Marlene. I love Taylor. She's perfect. She is. She's a great dog.
Daddy?
All the yellow flowers.
Marlene!
Barret! Damn, he looks so good.
I'll come back.
So, what now?
Wait, Cloud's got his Buster Sword and he's got materia. That's not my materia. The feather.
Sephiroth.
He's not gone.
Still out there.
Yep.
I thought you beat him.
I try, dude. It said defeated.
We can. We will. Count me in.
If it's to be a hunt, you could use a nose like mine.
Of course, 13. Thank you.
I'm in too.
I know you are, Barret.
Destroy the whole planet, doesn't he? An enemy of hers is an enemy of Avalanche.
Rain. They haven't seen rain in this game. It's Zack. And a friend? What the?
Almost there, Cloud. We're almost there.
What? Excuse me, what? Zack and Cloud, then Cloud and Aerith?
I miss it. The steel sky.
I would be lost, drifting alone.
The unknown journey will continue. Holy shit! That was it! Oh my god! You did it! You finished! I thought I was gonna keep going! Oh my god! But what was that at the end? It was Zack and Cloud! Is it like an alternate dimension or something like that? Oh man, this is only part of the Final Fantasy VII story. It was only the part of the original that takes place in Midgard. Yeah. And the second game doesn't come out, or the second part doesn't even come out until late this year or 2024 early. I told you the FF games have a regular part and a bonkers part. You're getting to the bonkers part? Wow. That was a wild game. In the beginning, it seemed pretty mild. Like, we're a group of an organization that's trying to save the planet by destroying Mako reactors, right? It's like, okay, blowing up reactors to try and, that are is sucking lifeblood from the planet. This is pretty cool. And then we get the Shinra Tower, and it just accelerates exponentially from there. Like, what the hell is happening? Wow. We actually finished it, though. It seemed like it was never gonna end. But I... Prior knowledge, by saying that there is another... Knowing that this is another game, it can't end here, right? But I didn't know what it was gonna end on here. Because I've never played any other Final Fantasies besides 14 before this. I have Final Fantasy 15 that I need to play through as well, but I've never played any of the other Final Fantasies. Because I always thought that all the Final Fantasies were a singular story. Do I recognize any of the names here? I don't. But apparently Big survived in the end. I'm guessing Jesse didn't, though. How did Big survive, though? We were there when he died. Or I guess he maybe like passed out from shock or something like that. But they didn't show Jesse. They didn't show Wedge. Well, Jesse we watched die as well. But I say that like I think that she... That I know she died. But I also thought that Big's died as well. Because we were there when he died. Died. So Jesse might still be alive. Wedge, we don't know. We thought he died when the plate fell. But then we didn't see anything confirming that. And then in the tower, he was there. And then he got, like, thrown out of the tower by the shadows, or the shades, the whispers, whatever they're called. But we don't know if he's dead either, because we haven't seen a body for that. Holy moly. This story is wild. Man. Play the original while you wait for the rest of the... Wait for the rest to come out? I don't know. I don't know if that would be good or not, to be honest. I mean, we have a bunch of other games. I have a bunch of other games that I want to play through. So it's kind of an... I guess... Kind of a nice pause to play other games before that one comes out. But if I play the original, I feel like I'm gonna experience the full story before the remake story comes out. I don't know if I want to do that though, to be honest. I think I'm just gonna wait until the second game comes out. Because this is really good. Like I said, the beginning seemed kind of mild, and it just accelerated so fast, exponentially, into wildness. Like, way past blowing up Mako reactors to save the planet. Holy moly. That was an experience. Like, at the end there? That was insane. Nothing I would have expected out of this game. Hey, it's Aerith in the beginning. The flower seller. The flower peddler. In the beginning, the mission right there in the train. When they hired Cloud as a merc. Oh man, this seemed like so long ago. You went to space, that's how you know you're playing FF. True, for my two games I've played, Final Fantasy XIV and this, we've both gone to the edge of creation to save the world. Wild. Man, I hope Jesse survived. She was such a happy, innocent person. Innocent, but... Still, I hope she survived. Magically, somehow. Somehow Wedge... Or not Wedge, Big survived. Man, that was so good. And to think the original is just... I think the original is just a 2D top-down game, right? If I'm not wrong. I can't imagine being a person that played the original and then from a 2D top-down ARPG, I think, right? To go to this 3D high graphics kind of stuff. That must be insane. Oh, it is 3D? Oh, okay. Well, I never did play the original, so I don't really know. But still, this game is, graphically speaking, is beautiful. It is amazingly well done, graphic-wise. I was hoping we would see the motorcycle soldier again. I was hoping we would see him when we were fighting the Transformer near the end. Well, it has really good cutscenes anyway. It's very basic 3D from the dawn of the times. Oh, okay. Do they have us in a Wall Street here in these cutscenes? Well, we're doing the dancing. Man, that the Wall Street was probably some of the best parts of the game. With the dancing and the squat off with the gym bros. Man, that was so fun. But it's mostly from like a top-down view. Okay, that's what I thought. I mean, I'd be so happy if Jesse ended up surviving somehow. Like how Biggs did. Jesse did not need to die. I like how they have this. It's like snippets of all the important parts. To be honest, I didn't think I'd like this game as much as I did. I was prepared to get like a 6 out of 10 from a non-previous player standpoint, but I'd damn near say it's 9 out of 10 for me. Maybe close to I think 9.5 out of 10. I think that'd be my official rating on it. As a non-previous player. Maybe the story is different, a little bit different, or a little bit more well-told in the previous game. In the non-remake, that is. But you didn't like the battle system with the aggro switching? I mean, yeah, that's true. I do have my gripes about this game. With the combat. Literally only about the combat. With the AI. And the aggro switching. That's... If I try and think of anything other than that, it's literally just that. Oh, it is number 2! That was at the apartment there. It was number 2, I couldn't remember. But yeah. My only gripe with the game is the combat with the AI and aggro switching. Like, if I was Cloud, and I was gaining all the aggro for enemies, and I was like, okay, Cloud's got the aggro, so I switch to someone else. All the enemies immediately switch their aggro to the person I switch to. That, and sometimes in combat, the AI would just not do anything. Oh, here's Wall Street. Or, is it Wall... It's not Wall Street. Wall City? Oh yeah, Aerith in that red dress. Woof! She looked real fine in that, I'll tell you that much. And of course, Cloud. Oh, the honeybee inn. Oh, that was such a fun time. I still don't get why people would choose Tifa over Aerith, though. Walmart, yeah. Walmart's name. But, I still don't get why people... I mean, Tifa's great, but Aerith, I don't know. I feel like she's... I don't know. Aerith would be my choice. No one cares if you think Aerith looked fine. Okay. All the characters look fine. Like, Rude, right there? He's a slick-looking man. Barret? That's a Chad of a man. Cloud? He's something. I don't know. All the characters look great. Biggs, Wedge, Jesse, all the side characters, they look great. All the characters were really, really well done. Man, I hated that chariot fight. Because he wouldn't stop charging and stuff like that. Yeah, right there. That big scene right there. That's right before he died. And obviously he didn't die, because at the end we saw him waking up. And that's where Jesse died. I'd be happy if Jesse somehow came back. I'm surprised they brought Biggs back. I wrote Biggs and Jesse off with those their death scenes there. But somehow Biggs made it back. I don't know how. Yes, that cat. What is that cat? That's gotta be played into the next game, right? It has to be. That cat. Yeah, look, that's the only time we ever saw it. When the plate fell, and it just, like, he was very angry that the plate fell. And that's the only time we saw him. What a wild game. I was not disappointed. Even come from Death Stranding, which I absolutely love Death Stranding. I would give Death Stranding a 10 out of 10. I cannot wait to play the second game of that. But still, this was really good. Some parts were a little stale, I think. Like with the wards and stuff like that near the end, where I just had to go through four or three different wards. Kind of just to draw out the end. But for the most part, the story is insane. You go from being an ex-soldier to a merc for hire for the eco-terrorist group, Avalanche, from blowing up reactors to becoming friends with an ancient Aerith to the Shades, like, invading... Not really invading, the Shades or whatever, trying to coerce Destiny and stuff like that. And Aerith getting captured, us going to save her, and then all hell breaking loose when we save Aerith, pretty much. With all sorts of stuff happening. It's a JRPG, you are lucky it wasn't 100 wards. You're not wrong. That's true. That's like the only part where I was like, this is kind of unnecessary, like, prolonging of the story. Son of Gargakev, yo, long time no see. Skyhaze, yo, how's it going? You back under a new name, huh? You had to change it? I see. You guys, we're doing good. We just finally finished Final Fantasy VII Remake Intergrade after thinking it was gonna end so many times in a row, but it finally came to an end tonight with a wild story, and I am seriously looking forward to the next one for sure, because this story just got so wild. With Sephiroth and stuff like that. Apparently Sephiroth is still alive, so. You still streaming for a bit? Probably not. I was only probably streaming... I initially said I was going to stream for about 4 hours. And then I'm like... And then I got kind of sucked into this Final Fantasy VII story. And then I played it till completion. So. That's about all I have in me tonight, I think. Plus, I think I'm getting... I think I'm catching a cold because I went to visit my parents this weekend and my mom had a cold, so I think I'm catching that, so. So I don't want to stay up too late. I kind of want to get some rest and hopefully prevent that. I was expecting some Gothic Arcalos. Did you replay it? I have not played Arcalos in a long time. Yeah. It is Sunday? Yeah, it is Sunday. I've kind of been on a single-player binge with getting through games that I've really wanted to play. With, like, Death Stranding and this game, like that. But yeah, I really haven't played Arcalos in a long time. Which I kind of wanted to do. I kind of want to pick up again, but I know it's a long story. When do you stream again? My official schedule is Thursdays and Sundays. But I occasionally put in some bonus streams like on Tuesday, Thursday, Friday. Well, not Thursday because that's official streams. Oh, achievement unlocked. Destiny's Crossroads. Oh, I finished. Okay. But yeah, my official schedule is Thursday, Sundays currently. Once I graduate college here in 2 months, I'm going to revise my schedule. It'll probably be 3 times a week. But, yeah. Look how guilty he looked when he said he hasn't played in a while. I know! I haven't played in a while. It's a great game, but I've also wanted to play these games for a long time, so I've kind of put Arcalos on pause for the time being. Chapter selection has been unlocked. Open the main menu system to replay any chapter using your current characters, weapons, and materials. This is a great way to tackle uncompleted missions, find story elements you missed first time through, and more thoroughly explore Midgar. Hard difficulty is now unlocked and can be selected by going to chapter selection and playing one of the characters. In this difficulty, items cannot be used and all HP is restored at rest spots. However, certain manuscripts are only available in this difficulty setting. Really? A record of your adventure can be played. Or it can be viewed from system play log in the main menu. The log contains information from battle records to story branches. Interesting. You playing poopy? I haven't heard that a long time. Other new features, bonus XP and AP. You'll now earn twice as much XP and 3 times as much AP. Oh, shit. New combat simulators become available from Hojo's lab. To test it out, select chapter 17... And skipping the bike minigame. The bike minigame cannot be skipped from the pause menu. Accessing intermission content. You can now have access to a portion of the story that revolves around a new character, Yuffie. To access this content, press right trigger while in the title menu. What? Is it like DLC? Can you postpone that Metal Gear Solid for Arcalos Thursday? Ooh. It's a good question. It is a good question. I was looking forward to playing Metal Gear Solid Rising, Revengeance next, but, I think... Okay, how about this? I play Metal Gear Rising, Revengeance on Thursday, and then Sunday is Arcalos. Because on Thursdays, I usually have more time to stream. Or, not Thursdays. On Sundays, I have more time to stream. Thursdays are a little bit iffy on what's going on. So, I could do that. I mean, it's only right. You Sunday for Arcalos. That's true. I originally planned Arcalos to be only Sundays because cozy Sundays. And I feel like Arcalos is very cozy, so. You always say that? I do. It's just depending on the weekend or on the time. Context, like if I have school projects going on. Currently, I don't really have anything barring work, like schoolwork on Sundays, I think, for the most part. You cannot leave the menu at this time. You can I guess I save. 18 chapters. I thought this game was going to end after chapter like 12. How long did it take us? 33 hours. That's not bad. That's not bad at all. Okay, so I guess I have to go back to the main menu? Title screen? I saved, so... What is this intermission? Is this actually like canon and stuff for this game? Should I play through this? with what's her name, Yuffie or something. I might have to do that sometime. Or is that like a placeholder until the new game comes out, maybe? Regardless, we finished this game. We finished it. It was a great experience. My official rating is 9 or 9.5 out of 10. And yeah, I think that's all I'm really going to do for tonight's stream, because I should probably get some rest and hopefully not get sick. And just get as much rest as possible. But for the upcoming week, my official stream schedule is Thursday. Thursday, we will be taking care of Metal Gear Solid Rising Revengeance. We'll take a look at that, because that's a really short game, apparently. And I got on spring sale, so we'll take a look at that. And then on Sunday, you convinced me, Sky Hayes, or Son of Gargakev, your new name. I'll dive back into more Arkalos, because that game is still in the back of my mind, like, I really want to play it, so. Take care, bro, and have a good night, then, you too, Ellen. Yeah, I appreciate you stopping by. I'm still gonna call you Sky Hayes, because that's, it's just habit, but, yeah. That's it for tonight's stream. Thursday, Metal Gear Rising Revengeance. Sunday is more Arkalos for Cozy Sunday Gaming. And then anything between then is bonus streams, which would maybe possibly be Tuesday or Friday, depending on if I want to play something. I play some games off stream that I don't know if would be good stream games, but you never know. I missed you guys, had. Miss you too, man. It's great to have you back. But yeah, that's it for tonight's stream. I appreciate it.